We're in the laboratory here at the Gray Fossil Site in northeastern Tennessee. This is a rhinoceros skull that was excavated just outside our Natural History Museum. It's an extraordinary fossil locality, actually extraordinary for the entire world. It's a regional, national, and international treasure. It dates to between 4.5 and 7 million years old. The place is astounding in terms of what kinds of science, research, and education that we're able to do here. We invite everyone to come out, become engaged in this fossil site, and learn about our history.
Right now, what he's working on is we found a tapir humerus. If you're familiar with tapirs today, they live in Central America, South America. There's a species that lives in Asia. They look kind of like a pig with a trunk, but they're actually more closely related to rhinos and horses, and that's what he's working on right now. And essentially what he'll do is this clay is really easy to work. It's really soft. He'll just simply expose the bone. Once there's enough visible that he can survey it, he'll survey it in, and then he'll dig around it and actually put a plaster jacket around it. Because unfortunately, because it is clay, our bones are typically cracked or broken. You know, they're not perfect bones. And so he needs to be able to basically contain it and get it into the lab. This was a sinkhole that collapsed, became basically a pit then, and it filled in to become a pond. So it wasn't that it was necessarily a natural trap, it was just a watering hole. And so you think of your day-to-day activities around a watering hole, that's why the animals are here. If you can imagine, you know, the limestone that had a cave and collapsed, you know, we would have had limestone walls all the way around us. Well, the interesting thing is this organic-rich, dense clay that filled in this pit is actually far more resistant to weathering and erosion than the residuum that you see around us. When the limestone weathered away, it just turns into this red clay with rocks and gravel in it. Well, that stuff breaks down and weathers away very easily compared to this dense, organic-rich clay. So given enough time, you basically took what was once a low spot and turned it into a high spot as everything around it weathered away. It was just day-to-day activity around a watering hole. And so really, that's why our common animals are things really like turtles, frogs, salamanders, those are our most common animals. But the things that you guys are excited about are the saber-toothed cat, the short-faced bear, the cool things.
There are all kinds of opportunities for taking part out here at the Natural History Museum and Gray Fossil Site. No matter what your background or resources, we invite you to become more engaged in this regional, national, and international treasure. So yeah, if we, right here, if we could get down